Divyansu, we'll start with explaining the recruitment process through which you got selected for your job.
Sorry, sir, I didn't get the question.
So all those processes, recruitment and selection process, through which you got your first job after BTech.
So when I was in seventh semester, then few companies came to my college, and one of them was TCS. So I sat for the TCS recruitment drive, in which first round was aptitude, and then do I need to explain the TCS campus placement drive also? Or
yes, tell me for whatever. But also, if you can find any significance of that step, you can also tell me that.
So the first round was aptitude test, which I believe organizations are trying to find in people, if they are able to solve these problems. Then the next round is technical round, in which they check the technical skills of the person. And then comes the HR round, in which they ask a few questions and check the person's communications and all.
So the entire role of HR round was to check your communication.
Not just that. Apart from that, if I'm employable, if I have the other, as far as my understanding is there, sir. So TCS looks for ethics also in a person. So I believe they might be looking into those aspects as well. Also, they were asking if I can work in any location they want me to go and work. Other than that, if I am able to work in night shifts and all, so if I'm flexible enough, so those things also they try.
So now, when you have worked already for two and more year of the more year in that company, and you know what kind of job profiles that you are being offered or all the other freshers are being offered, so if I'll ask you to critique their recruitment process or selection process and bring some changes in that, because now you are senior to that company. And what are the changes that you suggest, that you might suggest in their selection process, and for to what, and to solve what problem? If I'll ask you any suggestion, what will you say?
Actually, I would like to highlight something that has already been done after those recruitment drives. So after my batch, I believe after 1 year or so, they started the digital recruitment drive, in which they ask the contestants, the participants whether they have the knowledge of the digital platforms, which are artificial intelligence or data science, etc. And they give them the coding questions also, and whether they can actually code in that language. So that actually evaluates a person in a better way. So basically in a development project or something. So I believe, and they are paying those people also who are able to clear those tests with a better score. They pay them more, and the people who aren't able to clear that, they are hiring them also, but they are paying a bit less than those people. So quite a lot has already happened there. So if it was in my hands, so I would like to relax the basic criteria, 60% is the basic. Although it's there for the basic things, the person should be he should at least get 60% in the 12th standard or graduation. However, I feel that if a person is looking beyond the academics, let's say he goes for the extracurricular things, so the organization needs that kind of people also. So it should relax the norms for the qualifying marks which are there, and they should at least give the person a chance to prove himself, whether he has the basic aptitude, whether he has the other things that they are
okay looking. So can you again describe or give me detail about what happened when you got selected in the company, like what was the induction process or the first the few months that happened in your company?
So we were called for training in Trivandrum, which is the capital of Kerala. So there we had to report, and then they took all our documents and all the documentation and all was done on the very first day. Then they did some orientation. They told us about the company. They told
you'll be telling me with reference to the OD, reference to the OD or HR practices. What were the objective they were trying to achieve through that process?
Okay, so the very first thing, one of the major things that I remember was, so they told us not to to call anyone by sir. So basically, what I believe is they want to remove the hierarchical structure that is there, and the people who call their seniors as sir. So that sort of thing they don't want in their organization. They want everyone to call the others by their first name, which is actually very formal also, and which is a normal thing in the Western countries. So that was one of the things where they were telling that all the seniors are also there is no such hierarchy here. However, that was not completely true. Still they are trying to do that, so that's one of the things. Other than that, another thing that they did on the second day was they did a session on Reiki, which is to relax the mind, because the newcomers were a bit baffled or a bit anxious about how the things will be. So that actually took a little, that showed a little care about the employees that they are taking, and that they care about their well-being also. So that was another good thing that they did.
So Divyansu, what is the attrition rate of your company? How many people change their job or leave your company every year?
I'm sorry, sir. I don't remember.
What is the attrition? What is the attrition rate of your company? We don't know, or you did not get my question.
No, sir. I don't know actually. I don't know the figure of it.
Okay. So if I'll say, how many people who joined from your batch, when you joined the company, how many people whom you know joined the company with you?
Right. So how many are still there, or how many already?
How many of them left after 1 year?
Okay. So, I believe at least half of them they left already, sir.
In 2 years.
Right, sir. In after 1 year they started leaving, because TCS has the policy you cannot leave the organization within 1 year, otherwise there will be some penalty. So a few of them actually waited for 1 year. Somehow it should pass, then they left the organization.
So why there is a very high attrition at your company?
At the initial stage, right? So, sir, I believe the reason for this is since since TCS is one of the mass recruiters, so basically it recruits. I believe that it recruits with the perspective that that many of the people who are joining us, they will be leaving. So they are actually hiring more people because of that reason. That is one of the things that I think that is there. Other than that, even the students who are there in the college, so for them, they want a placement, a job in a company, especially if that company is, especially if that company is as good as TCS or Infosys, let's say. So that is one of the things. So they want to get some job after their degree. So that is one of the reasons why many people actually take the job. However, they are not interested in moving further in this field also. So that is another reason, sir. Apart from that, one thing which I felt was the salary aspect also. So some people actually want to grow a bit faster than others, which is justifiable also. So they switch in order to get higher salary in less amount of time. So that was another reason, sir.
Okay. So why you didn't change the company? So what is the reason that you are still there at TCS?
Actually, in TCS, in Tata, actually, there is one opportunity which goes by TAS. So Tata Administrative Services. I was actually looking forward to join TAS, and other than that, I was actually looking for management degree. So
you basically prefer to stay there and prepare for the examination,
right? Because if I switch, then again I need to adjust to the new company, new place. Then again, some other kind of expectation. Here in TCS, the work-life balance is actually one of the USPs which I felt. So here they don't stress much to work like more than the normal working hours, and they don't normally they don't say to work apart from the normal working hours. So that was actually comfortable for me to prepare for the management preparation as well. Apart from that, I really wanted to be there with the Tata Group because I admire this okay. organization.
So why do you want to go for a higher degree which is not a technical degree and also not in sync with your experience? And after Malab, you can also pursue all those MBA based or business management based degrees. So why are you picking ODCL as for your educational choice?
Okay, sir. So my interest was towards the HR field, which is there. So when I was looking to apply for the institutions, the good HR institutions, then I came across the name of this, and then I researched a bit more about it. So I came to know about the ODCL course also, which is closely related to HR. However, it's a bit different, and this being a socialistic kind of institution, so that actually pushed me towards increased my level of interest towards the ODCL course. And when I researched a bit more about ODCL course, also I can recall one instance in my company itself, sir, where we are working in agile methodology. So what the organization has done is they have actually implemented the agile workspace kind of model for the employees. So that raised my interest that why they are spending so much money for the employees' comfort or let's say on the employees' seating arrangement basically. So how it will help the organization so I started to understand a bit about it, and I asked a few people and I researched also. So I came to know it comes from organization development practices. So then I so that thing was already there in my mind. So when I saw this this sort of course is there, so I applied for this course.
So do you know any other university which provide similar course than what we do here at TIS?
Sorry, sir, I don't know any such university which provides such a degree.
Okay. So you don't know, or you didn't research about this?
I feel I wouldn't have researched enough, sir, because I am not, like, I don't know about it.
So the next point, the next question would be, if you pass, if you will go through the curriculum and syllabus and it will pass the ODCL program, in what kind of industry you would like to work? Similar to what you are currently working, or you would like to change the industry?
Okay. Sir, after passing out from this course, I can join any kind of industry. So I don't mind joining the IT industry also, because I know how the industry works. However, it would be good if I would be able to join some other vertical of the same of the organization apart from IT, because then I will be able to. Sorry, sir. I think I didn't understand your question.
No, I just asked, do you also like any other industry where you would like to go?
Right. So I would be more than happy to join any other industry also, because anyway.
Any preference? Any preference other than IT?
Okay. No such preference, sir, because I'm not very much aware about the specific.
Okay, if I'll ask you, which industry needs OD based practices most, and why?
Sorry, sir, I don't understand the question basically. So
the question is like if I consider all the companies from one particular industry similar, which is more or less it might be. So if I'll ask you, or if I try to find industry which needs the OD based practices or OD based intervention most right now, so which industry would it be? Or where do you find that, which pick any industry where you think that OD interventions are very important there right now?
So I believe the public sector industries, they need the public sector enterprises, they need the
public OD. Sector is not industry. Public sectors are, of course, public sector needs most of the OD interventions because of their low effectiveness or low productivity. I'm talking about pick any industry.
I got a bit confused about the industries basically. So
your company is from IT industry, there could be automobile industry, and hospital industry, hospitality, tourism, agricultural based, food based industry, so all these manufacturing, certain kind of manufacturing.
Thank you so much, sir, for clarifying my doubt. I think the agricultural industry would be needing the OD professionals very much right now, because it needs some transformation to make it more relevant to the changing needs of the hour.
So have you also gone through the curriculum that we provide at ODCL?
Right, sir. I have gone through the curriculum.
So do we have anything which basically can be used for agricultural industry? If I'll ask what component of our curriculum or what training that we provide, you can go and use for agricultural industry, or in what ways?
I believe like many of the components can be used. So for instance, let's say the leadership the leadership course which is there, which intends to grow the leaders also, which are the potential leaders in an organization, and taking care of the leaders which are already there. So there is a concept called I'm sorry, sir, I'm not able to recall exactly. So however, so actually it's stressed that the leadership which is needed in future, or even nowadays, the leadership, the kind of leadership that is needed. So basically the leader cannot just force or implement or just tell the employees to do something. It should like the HR or basically like through the HR or in some other way, their vision should be clear to all the employees.
So, Divyansu, to me, I won't say ki matlab kuch direct wo chahiye tumhe, any such recommendation which will direct help you. बट ये है कि तुम प्रेजेंटेशन थोड़ा और इम्प्रूव कर सकते हो अपने कंटेंट का. कंटेंट इज ओके, कैरियर ओरिएंटेशन भी थोड़ा और ठीक कर सकते हो. ठीक है, मतलब वो कन्विंसिंग नहीं नजर आ रहा. व्हाई डू वांट टू चेंज, यू नो, व्हाई डू वांट टू गो फॉर ओडी, व्हाई डू वांट टू क्रिएट योर कैरियर इन ओडी, यू नो, थोड़ा और मतलब प्रॉमिसिंग लगना चाहिए कि भाई यू विल एंजॉय द जॉब, यू विल बी मोर प्रोडक्टिव देयर, है ना, योर कंट्रीब्यूशन विल बी वेरी हाई देयर. फिर एनालिटिकल एबिलिटी भी तुम जहां जहां पे सोचना होगा वहां पे एटलीस्ट यू आर नॉट इवन ट्राइंग, है ना, तो थोड़ा और ट्राई करना पड़ेगा. और सब्जेक्ट नॉलेज में भी जैसे व्हेन आई एम आस्किंग यू एवरीथिंग, जैसे कंपनी के प्रोसेसेस हैं उसको ओडी टर्म में बताने के लिए, है ना, जो रिक्रूटमेंट है उसको ओडी टर्म में, तो थोड़ा उस तरीके से मतलब एटलीस्ट योर लैंग्वेज शुड बी इन, मतलब एचआर पीपल और ओडी पीपल का थोड़ा बहुत तो ओरिएंटेशन में बोलोगे ना,
राइट,
तुम्हारे ओरिएंटेशन में अगर ये काम किया गया तो ऐसा क्यों किया गया, तो वो टीम बिल्डिंग कराना चाहते थे, वो बैरियर हटाना चाहते थे, विच एक्सरसाइज फॉर डू व्हाट, ट्रेनिंग का ये कंपोनेंट क्यों था, है ना. इवन जो एचआर इंटरव्यू लेता है तो उसके कई रोल होते हैं. इट वॉज नॉट जस्ट देयर टू चेक योर कम्युनिकेशन स्किल. कम्युनिकेशन स्किल तो आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस से भी चेक हो जाएगा. So HR interview is there to check matlab your compatibility with the organization, organization's compatibility with you, hai na, how much ambitious you are you more ambitious than what the job offers you, hai na, to ye sab cheeze bhi dekhte hain. To usi hisab se jab attrition rate bahut zyada tha to tum suggestion bhi tum acha de sakte the soch ke thoda, which you basically what you did, you just told me what they have changed. तो तुम्हें थोड़ा और सोच के समझ के थोड़ा और होता है ना, एज अ लीडर तुम्हें इंटरव्यू देना पड़ेगा. यू कैन जस्ट ब्रेक द थॉट प्रोसेस ट्रेडिशनल वे से सोच के तुम नई चीजें भी बोल सकते हो. ठीक है
सर, थोड़ा आइडियाज आ ही नहीं रहे थे, मतलब
हाँ वही तो हम भी सोच रहे थे कि ऐसा क्यों है कि तुम्हारे